नमस्कार। डेटॉल एनडीवी बनेगा स्वस्थ इंडिया के लॉन्च के इस कार्यक्रम में आप सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत। मैं अमिताभ बच्चन हूं। देखिए, 5 साल पहले मैं एक अभियान लेकर आपके बीच आया था, स्वच्छ भारत का अभियान। वो 2014 तक या जो साल था तब तक हमारे माननीय प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के पूरे देश के लिए एक स्वच्छ भारत अभियान चलाया गया था। उस साल हम एक बस लेकर चले थे, स्वच्छ एक्सप्रेस। ये बस 7 राज्यों में 350 गांव में घूमी। हम लोगों को बताते रहे कि साफ सफाई कितनी जरूरी है, गंदगी कितनी जानलेवा है। हमने 281 करोड़ रुपए की राशि इकट्ठा की, 281 करोड़। इससे शौचालय बने, उनके रखरखाव की व्यवस्था हुई। दूसरे साल हमने स्वच्छता की पाठशाला चलाई, कोशिश की कि बच्चों को साफ सफाई का महत्व जो है वो बहुत बचपन से समझ में आए, साफ रहने की आदत लग जाए। मैंने कहा था कि देखिए, कम उम्र में बच्चे जो सीख लेते हैं वो उम्र भर उनके साथ रहता है। तीसरे साल आपको याद होगा मेरे 10 गज, मैंने आपसे ये प्रार्थना की थी कि हर नागरिक अपने घर के आसपास के 10 गज साफ रखे। ये जितनी क्रांति पूरे देश को बदल देगी, आने वाले वर्षों में भी ये सिलसिला चलता रहा, इसमें नए आयाम जुड़ते रहे। चौथे साल हमने क्लीन कंपोस्ट एंड सेग्रीगेट ड्राइव चलाए और 5वें साल वायु प्रदूषण पर ध्यान दिया। ये पूरे पर्यावरण को लेकर हमारी चिंता और मुहिम थी, जिसके बहुत अच्छे परिणाम आते रहे। आपको मालूम होगा कि इस 2 अक्टूबर तक पूरे देश को खुले में शौच से मुक्त रखने का हमने लक्ष्य रखा। मुझे उम्मीद है हम जल्द ही उस घोषणा में भी शामिल होंगे। आखिर इस 2 अक्टूबर को महात्मा गांधी के जन्म के 150 साल पूरे हो रहे हैं। आज मैं इस मुहिम को कुछ और आगे ले जाने के लिए आपके पास आया हूं। स्वच्छ इंडिया तब तक पूरा नहीं होगा जब तक वो स्वस्थ इंडिया में न परिवर्तित हो या बदले। हमें एक ऐसा देश बनाना है जहां बच्चे सेहतमंद हो, जहां बच्चों का जन्म अंदेशे से ना भरा रहता हो। क्या आपको पता है कि अभी जो 40 बच्चे जन्म लेते हैं उनमें से एक की मौत जन्म के पहले ही हो जाती है, और 5 साल से कम हर 25 बच्चों में एक को हम बचा नहीं पाते। ये जरूरत बदलनी चाहिए। हमें स्वस्थ बच्चे चाहिए, हमें स्वस्थ माताएं चाहिए। अगर इन्हें सही पोषण मिले, सही देखभाल मिले, तो भविष्य की बुनियाद बहुत मजबूत होगी। हम सरकारी एजेंसियों को अपने साथ लेंगे, हम स्वास्थ्य के जानकारों से बात करेंगे, कोशिश करेंगे कि सेहत का ऐसा एजेंडा तैयार हो जो सभी राज्यों में लागू हो सके, जो कागजों से उतरकर छोटे बच्चों और उनकी माओं तक पहुंच सके। हम बहुत बड़े बड़े लक्ष्य लेकर नहीं चल रहे हैं, हम बहुत छोटे छोटे सपने देख रहे हैं। एक खिलखिलाते हुए बच्चे का सपना, उसके गोद में लिए एक सेहतमंद माँ का सपना, एक ऐसे समाज का सपना जिसमें गंदगी और बीमारी ना हो। तो आइए हम सब मिलकर ऐसे ही समाज को बनाने का एक छोटा सा कदम उठाएं। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका। नमस्कार।
थैंक यू वेरी वेरी मच
फॉर
स्पेयरिंग द टाइम अगेन।
Thank you so much. We're together again.
He's really the motivating factor behind all of us, and we are
as always. Yes,
as always. Yeah. I just want to remind you of the impact that you have.
Oh gosh!
Remember, we did Save the Tiger.
Yes.
And there were only 1,400 tigers,
absolutely,
and it was going
yes.
down. Now it's nearly 3,000 tigers.
3,000. Wow!
And you just created such an impact, and you're doing that with this also. In 5 years, you've made everybody aware, and that's the whole idea,
no,
right?
I don't think that's entirely true. I think that the combined effort of television, of you know, pushing the idea across to millions of people,
right.
and all of you, and NDTV in particular, you know, really
and
congratulate
this,
you.
These youngsters
and of course,
as well.
No, I think in the last 5 years, what has happened is that we have defeated the cynicism of this country. I
that's
really
a
believe
good
that.
Point. Yeah.
I mean, we started in 2014 when the Honorable Prime Minister started with this whole attempt to clean India. The rate of toilet, say, was 40%. Today is 98%, 8 crore toilets. At that time, people said, this is again nonsense, never will happen.
Yeah.
But you imagine how this whole country has come together, people like you, sir.
It's not, I just feel that it was a much needed drug.
Yes, it was desperately needed.
What has happened is that our example is now being quoted the world over.
Yeah.
I mean, there are other countries in the West that are now coming to India to find out, you know, how the heck did you do all this?
I tell you something, it's so important what we're doing now is moving from 5 years of Swachh cleanliness to why it's important for hygiene. Yeah. Because, for example, at the time of birth, when a mother has a child, that's the biggest danger to her life and to the baby's life, because there's not enough cleanliness.
Yeah.
Just that one moment, if we are clean at that time, you can save 10 million babies.
Wow.
It's huge, and we are way behind on world statistics, but we'll catch up because we're moving from Swachh to Swasth.
Yeah. I think it's very important to put across these statistics, you know, Pranay. A lot of people are unaware of these facts.
Yes.
And I know that sometimes when it happens personally, unfortunately, people get aware of it. But I do believe that that a campaign such as this reaches out to millions of people.
Yes, that's very important.
And
we'll be reaching out with Dettol and others.
Yes, of course.
And meeting people and lots of things which will unfold. And these little ones will be
healthier.
Healthier,
and happier.
Cleaner and happier.
Smarter, happier.
आपका क्या नाम है? हाँ? Very good. मेरा नाम अमिताभ बच्चन है.
अच्छा.
ये क्या खेल रहे हैं आप?
He almost knows your name.
He almost knows my name.
Oh. Your name?
You know my name?
Yes.
What is it?
Amitabh
Bachchan.
Okay. Are not bad. Okay, on that we'll just have a quick look at what all of them have done over the last 5 years, the transition, the success, and then after that, after this video, there's a very, very special moment. Don't miss it. See you in a while from now.
A country is only as strong as its people. Its people are only as strong as long as they are healthy. For over 5 years now, NDTV Dettol Banega Swachh India has been talking about and promoting the need for a clean India.
S is for sanitation.
W for wash.
A is for air pollution.
C for cleanliness.
H for health.
H is for hygiene.
Hello and welcome to the launch of a very special campaign, Banega Swachh India.
Our campaign began in 2014, the same year that the Prime Minister began the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan for the country.
Agar 125 crore deshvasi tay kar le ki main kabhi gandagi nahi karunga to duniya ki kaun si taqat hai jo hamare shahar gaon ko aakar ke ganda kar sake aur ek rashtriya charitra ke roop mein bhi hamare samne sabse badi rukawat hai hamare charon taraf dikhai de rahi gandagi.
In our first year, a Swachh Express bus traveled through 350 villages across 7 states to educate people on the importance of sanitation and toilets and proper hand washing techniques. And we raised 281 crore rupees for toilet building and maintenance.
Final figure I'm being told is 281 crore rupees.
Yeah. Wow.
We introduced Swachhta Ki Paathshala in the second year and created a hygienic curriculum to encourage children to incorporate hygienic practices in their lives from a young age.
मुझे आप लोगों से मिलने का बहुत बड़ा सौभाग्य मिला है और आप मैं आपका टीचर बनूंगा. Okay?
In year 3, we continued with the agendas of year 1 and 2 and introduced Mere Das Gaz, where every citizen was asked to do their bit to clean India by keeping a personal 10 yards area around them clean.
स्वयं ये नियंत्रित करने की इसको हमें साफ रखना है तो इसी तरह पूरा शहर साफ हो जाएगा. क्या आप हमारे साथ हैं?
In year 4, we launched the clean compost and segregation drive, which when implemented would reduce greatly the garbage being generated by households and society at large. In year 5, we focused on air pollution, created a clean air agenda with the help of doctors and experts, and asked for manual scavenging to be eradicated. And now we're taking it further. A clean India leads to a healthy India, as health can only flourish when the environment around us is clean. There's nothing more precious to human life than health, and this starts at the womb. Right now, 1 in 40 babies die during childbirth. 1 in 25 children die before the age of 5. Most of these deaths are due to lack of hygiene, lack of access to clean water, pneumonia, diarrhea, and malaria. This year, as we embark on a new phase of our campaign to make the country cleaner and healthier, we'll focus on the well-being of our mothers and children. It all starts there. If hygiene and nutrition can begin there, a strong foundation can be laid for the future of a healthy society. We'll also work with governments and other experts to come up with a suitable health agenda that can be implemented in all states. This time, it's not just about the initiatives that you've taken to keep your surroundings clean, but you can contribute to our Swasth box. We'll curate this box specifically for postnatal care. These curated boxes can, if we raise enough funds to produce many of them, be given to mothers across the country, improving the chances of their baby surviving. We hope that by starting this, we can create communities who'll adopt these hygienic and healthy practices. We hope to get the Swasth box to every mother and child who needs one. It's imperative that our future is clean and healthy. We owe this to our children. Banega, banega, Swachh India.
Neezi, Swachh se Swasth tak kya? Pehle Swachh the, abhi Swasth hona bahut zaruri, bahut zaruri. Kaam kiya, khana khaya, haath dhoya nahi. Gande haath, bina dhakkan glass, pani pita wahi. Kitanu palta wahi. Germs tere haath dho ke piche pade haath dho le pehle bhai baad mein le khana bade manaveli ghar mein kharcha kam kyu karta kachra sadta jata gandagi bhi badhti jati 10 bimari tere piche lagi bach bimari se nanne bachcho ko bhi rakh rakh bimari se dur swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega ha ye short hai bhai swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega india swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega banega ke nahi bhai Swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega India har jawan ladka ladki soche parivartan karna jisme jitna dam hai utna jis tarah se khate peete usme kitna kya nutrition iska solution kya hai information leke pehle khud ko kare durust namrata ki bhasha dwara mita de sara dusht rog wala ration passion sahi jagah lag jave aur auraton ki fikre dil mein kathin kuch nahi koshish dwara aanganwadi aasha dwara ek swasth bharat bana de swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega banega kya swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega india swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega 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 swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega india Nays the bar in the house boy this is how we do it sawdhan public apne health pe dhyan do healthy ban jao kya swasth ban jao ek swasth jeevan bitao aur machao kya hai
brilliant
Thank you so much, sir. Really, congratulations. Thank you so much.
Looking forward to be a part of this.
ये आपने खुद ही बनाया है या अभी रैप?
जी हाँ, मैं खुद ले लिखा है।
कितना टाइम लगा आपको बनाने?
मुझे एक दिन लगा बनाने।
एक पूरा दिन?
एक पूरा दिन हाँ।
और ये रिदम वगैरह कैसे देते हैं?
रिदम वगैरह सेट करने में 2-3 दिन और लग गए तो 5-6 दिन एक हफ्ता लगा मतलब
बड़ा मुश्किल काम है भाई साहब कैसे कर लेते हैं आप
जी वही ऊपर वाले ने ब्लेसिंग्स दिया है मुझे टैलेंट से बख्शा है
थैंक यू सो मच
आप जैसे आप इतनी अच्छी एक्टिंग कर लेते हैं
भाई साहब हम तो आप ही से सीखते हैं
आपको कोई पकड़ नहीं सकता
थैंक यू सो मच
Brilliant.
Thanks.
And it's all your father's genes, remember? Thank your father. And mother.
Thank all my relatives.
That's what I tell my children.
Yeah. But I'm looking forward to be a part of this. I'm also concerned about the health of the people, you know. Yeah. I've written the verses thinking about my relatives who are living in villages. So I've thought of, you know, making a change through the verses. Now the young guys, these young people, they are listening to rap hip-hop music. So in hip hop, they might if they are listening to hip hop all the time, and if they are not getting the lyrics of vodka or sharab or pani daru and all, but they are getting aware of the song by listening to the lyrics.
Right.
They memorize. Usually, these young kids, they memorize the lyrics of rap songs. Now, if they memorize this song,
that's a good point.
Yeah, if they memorize this song, which is all written about the Swasth campaign, which is talking about how we shifted from being Swachh to Swasth.
Swachh is important for Swasth.
Yeah. So
this is the motivating force behind this. His team.
Thanks for joining us.
It's looking nice. It's sounding nice, and the way it's been presented, I think it's going to make a huge move in India.
You will make a difference as well, you youngsters.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Glad to be a part of this.
Wonderful.
As a representation of the youngsters.
Exactly.
Yeah. Being inside this, I'm very glad.
Thank you.
So
we'll see you again during the course of the.
Get up. After you.
No.
In the last 5 years, we've been emphasizing on how it's important to keep our surroundings clean, have access to toilets to make India open defecation free, and follow a very strict hygiene plan. This has naturally led to Swasth from Swachhata. To discuss in detail the importance of a healthy India and the challenges we face, joining us are Manisha Maiskar, Principal Secretary, Urban Development Maharashtra, Dr. Hemalatha from the ICMR, Nutrition. We have Sanjeev Kapoor here, celebrity chef and nutritionist. And we have Mr. Neeraj Jain, country head PATH, and Mr. Gaurav Jain, who you've already seen in the program, who is the senior vice president, Africa, Middle East, and South Asia for RB, and my colleague Ambika, and of course, Dr. Roy and Mr. Bachchan. Dr. Hemalatha, we can talk about health endlessly, but the foundation to everything, the key foundation to health will be cleanliness and hygiene practices, won't it?
Yes, if you do not wash your hands while ingesting food, along with food, you're also ingesting a lot of bacteria like typhoid, cholera, and many other pathogenic and non-pathogenic. And not only frank diarrhea and many gastrointestinal infections which are related to fecal-oral route and lack of personal hygiene, but also like while coughing, if a person is infected with tuberculosis, he'll be also disseminating bacteria in the environment. And not only that, this unhygienic environment can also promote inflammation, which actually promotes stunting and anemia. So it's not just health, but also undernutrition can be propelled by unhygienic environment.
Tell me something. We were just talking about the fact that at childbirth, there's the biggest danger to the life of the mother and the child. That's the time when they can most susceptible to either fall ill or even die. And that can be checked by simple methods. Wash your hands, keep clean water. How do we get people aware of this? No, go ahead, ma'am. Either one, it's okay.
You are better listening to me.
Carry on.
I'm sorry. Right from this 1,000 days windows are very important. Right from conception to 2 years of life, where the nutrition as well as hygiene play a very critical role. So when this window should be used as a good opportunity to make a healthy future and more prosperous future. So many studies have shown if nutrition is hampered during this period, that is conception to 2 years of life, nutrition and hygiene, the baby that is born is more likely to face frequent infections and is more likely to perform poorly in school because of cognitive impairment and also poor memory. And also as adults, these children are more likely to have diabetes and many other non-communicable chronic diseases like ischemic heart disease, stroke, and many other non-communicable chronic diseases as well as communicable diseases. So in turn, impacting the family's income and also the country's GDP. So this 1,000 days is very important to improve your own economy and also the country's economy.
Actually, what you were saying about cleaning your hands is, I think, very important. I remember seeing a short film some years ago. You know, Pranav, there's a village in South India where the average age of the kid has never gone beyond 5 years.
It's an isolated village, and none of the kids beyond 5 years have survived. And finally, you know, through education and through some of these campaigns, they were able to. But one of the very subtle and sublime campaigns was a father committing himself to the fact that if I follow these instructions and if my child survives, I will walk on my hands to the temple and thank the Lord. And we actually saw him walking several kilometers. He went upside down on his hands. And I thought it was very symbolic because he was walking on his hands to thank the Lord for saving his kid, and then came back and washed his hands symbolically to show that how important it is to, you know, clean your hands.
Beautiful, very moving, actually.
Very moving.
My hair standing.
In fact, like you're talking about the first 1,000 days, how important they are in a child's life. So, Neeraj, we really, when we look at the maternal mortality, India has done well. We've improved. Yes. Where does neonatal stand?
No, we still have a lot to do, both in maternal mortality and neonatal mortality. In neonatal mortality, we are 20% of the world's burden of neonatal mortality. We still lose about 600,000 children every year in the neonate phase, which is just the first 28 days.
28 days.
They don't make it beyond that.
Wow.
And a lot of that, 33% of that is because of infections. And as I think we would all agree that the infections are really coming because of bad hygiene practices. So, you know, I'm really proud to be here. I don't know if you remember, Mr. Bachchan, but I was here when you launched the Banega Swachh campaign 5 years ago on the panel.
Yes.
And it's great. I used to work for a water sanitation organization. Now I work for a health organization, and it's all together. This is absolutely critical. So,
can I just ask you?
Sure.
We were trying to do this, spread awareness for, the first 28 days. Is it a huge expense that has to be incurred, technology, incubators, or just simple practices which don't cost much?
It's a combination of demand and supply. So one is about behavior and how people are actually demanding for those services and actually going towards hygienic practices. But it's also how we improve our health systems. Right. How the public health system really sort of stands up and says, you know, we're going to make sure that we have clean water, we have hygienic practices, we have safe toilets in our health facilities. So a combination of these would definitely show results.
Right. So when we're really talking about, like you're saying, hygienic around, Manisha ji, I would like to come here and ask you, what impact do you see in urban Maharashtra with the Swachh Bharat mission, when we're looking at the health impact, what really do we see on ground?
I completely endorse this transition from Swachh to Swastha, because on ground this is exactly what we are seeing.
Really?
Maharashtra became ODF, urban Maharashtra became open defecation free in October 2017. And what we saw was that those communities where there was no open defecation any longer, children's school attendance had improved, cases of diarrhea had come down. And overall, the communicable diseases in those communities had drastically come down. Similarly, also, if there is no stagnant water now around, mosquitoes don't breed and cases of malaria also come down. So it's been our uniform finding across Maharashtra that with better Swachh indicators, the health indicators also improve. So it's actually very, very heartening.
I'd just like to ask something which is not entirely related, but I believe that, you know, Mumbai has been declared the urban city has been declared the most congested city as far as traffic is concerned. So do emissions have a similar problem as far as health is concerned? I'm sure it does.
Absolutely, it has. And therefore, Maharashtra has planned in a very big way in the next 5 years or 10 years for people to move from private cars to public transport.
Right.
Because one of the things which actually pollute the air around us is more and more private cars.
Yeah.
So with better cars, electric cars, more public transport, I think that is also going to be seen in the next 5 years or
Would
so.
Moving to cycles make a difference?
Yes, where it is, where the hill, where
yeah,
the
I,
climate
I just met some people and they said that, you know, they were thinking of creating bicycles for everyone, and a lot of Europe has that, you know, particularly in, say, cities like Amsterdam, where they you can rent out, or not really rent out, they just parked on streets. You just go and pick up a bike.
Yes, right. Wonderful.
You pay your
Wonderful.
Money. And wherever you go, you leave the bike there for someone else to use.
Yeah.
So something like that.
Yeah. Emission of
it's a huge financial burden for the congestion. And I ask, how is that possible? And this is a loss of opportunity, travel time,
yes,
and something like going into 60, 70,000 crore rupees. That's the amount of money that can be saved. By,
wonderful. Yeah.
But environmental pollution can also increase cardiovascular diseases.
Yeah. Yeah.
Can also increase the chance of tuberculosis.
Absolutely.
So definitely, yeah, it is connected with many communicable and non-communicable diseases.
Yeah. Right.
In all your amazingly popular programs, you do always highlight the importance of cleanliness for health. It's not just about great taste, which is important, but health as well, right?
100%. Actually, I'll come back to this later. I just want to highlight this 1,000 days concept. I'm so glad that it's been talked so much now. When I quit my job to start my own business, my father told me, first 1,000 days are very important for business. My brother told me, my friends told me that first 1,000 days are so important.
Your
focus
father,
on it.
Father treats you as a baby still.
Yes. So I hope and pray that this kind of narrative also gains momentum, and everyone knows that first 1,000 days you need to take care about everything. And I'm so glad that it's happening so much more. Coming back to the question of taste. Taste without hygiene, it's never. Especially in India, we have always known this. Place of a kitchen is only next to a temple in a household. We actually, most households in India, you would never enter a kitchen with your footwear, right? Somewhere down the line, we have lost those things. I think we need to come back to what we have learned. And this is something I'm sure with initiatives like this, we would always find some traction, and we can see. Sir, on your point on pollution and emission, I work very closely with the Clean Cooking Alliance, and it's about how people can be saved, especially women, can be saved from smoke that emits from cooking. Over 1 million women die every year because of smoke from cooking. So I think it's a 360 degree approach that we have to take. And no food can be tasty unless the basic tenets of hygiene are maintained, not just what we do to the food, what personal hygiene, the environment, everything. I think that's when we can say one bite is tasty. Yeah.
You know, you talked about women dying because of the smoke pollution while they're cooking. There's a small little institute in Gujarat which I've visited, and which is addressing this problem. So it's a very simple, innovative idea. The kitchen, or where they cook, where the smoke comes out, they made a little cubicle or barrel. So the smoke goes in that, and that barrel goes either up in the air, so they are not polluted, but in many cases, because that tube becomes hot, they wrap and bring water to it to create hot water.
Wow.
I mean, it's really innovative. It's a lovely little institute in Gujarat, where they're using the smoke that's coming out
to heat water,
water, and also to keep the person pollution free. Yeah.
We have a message from Mr. Raghubir Das, the Chief Minister of Jharkhand, where they've done quite a bit of work in the last year to reduce some of the incidences of communicable diseases and have raised the hygienic standards.
स्वच्छ शरीर में स्वस्थ मस्तिष्क का निवास करता है और इसको ध्यान में रखकर माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने एक निरोग भारत के निर्माण के लिए देश को आह्वान किए. मुझे एनडीटीवी परिवार को बहुत बहुत साधुवाद धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ कि जो लगातार स्वच्छता पर देश को जागरूकता करने का काम कर रहे हैं. और इसी तरह हमारा भारत का आन बान शान अमिताभ जी भी लगातार स्वच्छता के माध्यम से, चाहे एनडीटीवी के माध्यम से हो या अन्य माध्यम से, लगातार लोगों को जागरूकता करने का काम कर रहे हैं. और परिणाम स्वरूप 2014 के पहले भारत और आज 2019 के भारत में स्वच्छता के संदर्भ में काफ़ी बदलाव आए हैं. अभी और काफ़ी करने की ज़रूरत है. नीति आयोग ने भी झारखंड में स्वास्थ्य के क्षेत्र में तेजी से सुधार करने वाले राज्य की गिनती में आया है. तो इस तेजी से स्वास्थ्य सुधार के दिशा में ये शौचालय ODF स्वच्छता एक महत्वपूर्ण स्थान रखता है, और इसीलिए नीति आयोग ने तेजी से स्वास्थ्य के क्षेत्र में बढ़ता हुआ झारखंड का मानक एक स्वच्छता भी है, और उस स्वच्छता जो 2014 से के पहले किसी सरकार ने ध्यान नहीं दी थी, मोदी जी के मार्गदर्शन में हमारी सरकार झारखंड की जनता, झारखंड की बहनें, झारखंड के भाइयों, झारखंड के मीडिया के साथ एक जन आंदोलन बनकर आज हम 100% उस लक्ष्य को प्राप्त करने के करीब पहुंच चुके हैं।
The IOG report, Healthy States Progressive India is a comprehensive health index report released by the Niti Aayog, wherein the report ranks states and union territories innovatively on their year-on-year incremental change in health outcomes. The report has been developed by Niti Aayog with technical assistance from the World Bank and in consultation with the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Joining us now is Mr. Amitabh Khan, the CEO of Niti Aayog. So thank you so much for joining us. Could you tell us about the health index report developed by Niti Aayog and the World Bank?
Only 9% of India's children get adequate diet in this.
So breastfeeding ke liye kya hua?
Breastfeeding ko bhi.
Mr. Khan, can you hear me? Could you tell us about the health index report developed by the Niti Aayog?
Third is complementary feeding between 6 months and 24 months.
Exclusive breastfeeding up to 6 months.
6 months.
I think we can. I think it's.
Okay, I think we'll come back in a minute to that.
Yeah.
But it is a wonderful report that they're doing with Amitabh Kant is actually the real motivating factor, and it caused a bit of competition between states, who's number one, who's number 10, and that's a, you need to measure things, not just say keep improving. So I think they're making it quantitative and not just a qualitative assessment, and it looks dirty or
so
looks clean.
What exactly is the Niti Aayog doing? It's propagating healthcare.
It's creating an index of how clean or healthy a state is. So you can be the number one state because they have quantitative measures. So everybody wants to be number one or in the top three. So everybody, it makes you strive rather than just dream about doing something better. Or it's not a PR exercise.
Yeah. Is there a scientific process to be able to do that?
Yes.
So they rank states, and I believe 2 or 3 years down the line, the state that would be in the top three in Swachh Bharat would also be in the top three in this index.
Very
because the link is
the
so
linkage,
strong.
That'll show the linkage.
That's so strong. So maybe in 2021, we could really see this link in terms of these rankings.
Yeah. Very interesting, very interesting.
So besides sanitation, they also have things like education, infrastructure. So they've got a couple of different things which they're looking at.
Right.
And also, we were speaking about these direct links, Mr. Jain. Isn't also our economic future in a very, very big sense linked to our healthy future from a cleanliness point of view, leading to health and leading to a better economic future for India? Because
yeah,
less sick days and things
that. We talked about 1,000 days and everybody said that. Now, the point is this 1,000 days offers huge potential, and it's also an area of great vulnerability. The potential, because if you intervene in 1,000 days, you basically get rid of a lot of problems that a kid faces when he grows up, because most of it is irreversible. So imagine a kid born undernourished. He doesn't do well in school, therefore he cannot do well in his job, and therefore he lands back into a poverty. So it's a cycle that you are trying to break. And once you get that person out and he's more economically productive, once he's more economically productive, obviously it helps the country. It also leads to a lower healthcare cost burden to the country. Now, I was there in an Outlook conference on malnutrition about 2 weeks back. One of the experts said that malnutrition in India is about 11% of GDP. Now, our estimate, if you read any report, is anywhere between 6 to 8% to 10%. Now, we are growing at a rate of 7% every year. Imagine it has the potential to double this country's growth. And imagine what that could do for this country economically.
Okay, I think Mr. Kant is joining us. Mr. Khan, thank you for joining us. Can you tell us the health index report which has been developed by the Niti Aayog?
Well, we strongly believe that it's not possible for India to grow at high rates of 8 to 9% over a three-decade period without a huge focus on health and nutrition. Our view is that a lot of work needs to be done on health, and it's not the shortage of resources, it's not the shortage of food. There are several governance issues, and we believe that if you start ranking states, if you start putting it in public domain, if people get to know that good administration is good politics, then things will start changing. And what we've done in ranking states is that we've not gone by historical factors that Kerala will always be number one, but how has been the incremental change during the course of the year? And while historically Kerala, Andhra, Tamil Nadu have done well, what we find is that incrementally Rajasthan, Haryana, Jharkhand have done some path-breaking work and they have moved up the ladder. And we strongly feel that while the government is opening up 1,50,000 primary health centers across the country, while a major health insurance scheme which is bigger than, it covers more population than the population of USA, Europe and Mexico has been put together. It's one of the most ambitious health insurance scheme. The challenge really is about taking this whole movement of health and nutrition and converting it into a Jan Andolan. How do we make the people involved in a very big way in health and nutrition? Because in nutrition, for instance, it's 40% of the contribution is from sanitation, 40% is health, and only 20% is food. And therefore, sanitation and health play a very important role. Similarly, initiation of breastfeeding in the first hour is very critical. Ensuring that we have exclusive breastfeeding in the first 6 months is critical, and then complementary feeding. And therefore, awareness, spreading awareness, and bringing in behavioral change. And behavioral change is very critical. And therefore, community involvement, involving political leaders, involving religious leaders, and in many of the aspirational districts, which are actually the most backward districts of India, the Prime Minister calls them the aspirational district. In the 115 aspirational districts of India, we've seen some radical change in health. Some radical change in nutritional improvements have been seen. And this is because of people's participation in a very big way. And because there has been a huge behavioral change in many of these areas. For instance, in diarrhea deaths, we've moved towards rotavirus, we've moved towards pneumococcal, a whole range of new things have been done. And this has led to a massive improvement. So my belief is that ranking, putting it in public domain, naming and shaming and really pursuing what the Prime Minister has repeatedly said, cooperative and competitive federalism is going to bring in change in India in the long run.
Mr. Khan, this is Amitabh Bachchan. Thank you so much for being with us and giving us information on all that is happening on this front. It's most appreciable. I just wanted to ask, you, when we talk about numbering states and saying this particular state is done well and this is the statistics, is there a scientific method how you can find out what is happening in each state?
Yeah, so Mr. Bachchan, we have identified 23 indicators, and these indicators are like neonatal maternity under 5 maternality, we've looked at fertility rate, we've looked at TB, we've also looked at the period of time, some governance issues like the number of vacancies of doctors, the number of vacancies of ASHA workers, we've also looked at the period for which the doctors are available in a particular district. We've captured all these in 23 indicators. And we rank these districts on a real-time basis. The data flows into from these districts on a real-time basis. It is verified by a third party. And then, based on this verification, there is a real-time competition taking place between states and in the aspirational district between the districts. So there is a real-time competition taking place. Some states are moving up, some states are moving down, and at the end of the year, we announce the results. So unless and until on these indicators, we don't make the states compete, people must know why some states are doing well on mortality rate, why some are doing well on fertility rate, and why others are not doing well. And we must learn from each other's good examples. I mean, there have been some great examples. Araku Valley, for instance, has this great, unique examples of bike ambulances spreading out into tribal areas and tribal women being treated. Every single tribal woman have been treated in Araku Valley. Similarly, in Bahraich, there's been a huge amount of community participation there. And in Bijapur, where there were no doctors, the district collector has been able to hire doctors at high rates using a flexi pool, using the district mineral funds. So each district learns from each other. And based on that learning experience, many states move up and move down. And therefore, ranking really benefits all the states.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much.
Amitabh Kant, thanks very much for joining us and sparing the time to be here. And congratulations on this index. I agree with you. Naming and praising and naming and shaming are really important. You must know who's doing better. In your final analysis, just a small question about you are ranking so many things, and it's wonderful to see that. By the way, I would rank the Niti Aayog building where I used to work, I think before you were born. It's improved in cleanliness, leaps and bounds. Just your building, congratulations, and all the lose there, transformational change.
Thanks.
But in your scheme of things, how important is sanitation and health for a country's economy, because you focus eventually on the economy. Is this high on your priority or not that high?
So Pranav, it's a number one priority because it's not possible for India to be a world leader. It's not possible to be growing at high rates till we don't improve on social indices. And for us, health and nutrition is so critical because in India, only 27% of the women work. And unless we don't take it to the world average of 48%, it'll be not possible. If half your population doesn't work, it'll not be possible to grow at high rates. And therefore, gender parity is the key. And gender parity is important. We can succeed only if we can achieve our goals in nutrition and health standards. And therefore, the government is putting all its emphasis on health and nutrition. I mean, our whole emphasis is to improve our nutritional standards and advance so that we improve, we totally eliminate anemia, we remove stunting and wasting from our children, and we radically improve on our health standards, and that's why a huge focus has been put on primary health wellness centers. Imagine 150,000 primary health and wellness centers have been established, almost 15,000 of them in aspirational districts, and we've rolled out the biggest health insurance scheme to take care of the health standards in India.
It's time for a quick break, but stay with us. We'll be back with a lot more, and we're coming back really quickly.
We'll be right back.
Hello and welcome back to Banega Swasth India, our sixth year where we naturally progressed from talking about a Swachh India to a Swasth India. We're now joined by Dr. Harshvardhan, our health minister. Sir, in the last 5 years, we've all been talking about a Swachh India, clean India, and now we're talking about Swasth India and a healthy India. Do you think these conversations have created a conversation around the country over health, hygiene and sanitation?
Oh yes, significantly. I think there has been a sea change in the attitude of the people, and I think whatever the government has been able to do from its side, putting up over 10 crore toilets in the whole country and having more than 5,60,000 villages having become open defecation free. Very soon we'll be able to declare that the whole country has become open defecation free, and there is so much of thrust and so much of public awareness around these sanitation and hygiene issues. The sanitation coverage has gone up from 35% to almost over 97-98% in the whole country, and I think the happiest man around this is the health minister of the country, because I as a doctor also feel that everything that you do for sanitation or for Swasth Bharat, it contributes immensely to improvement of health status of the individuals at every level, and more particularly for the poor people, for whom the bad hygiene and the bad sanitation has its maximum adverse effect. So it has, I think we have seen there is a significant perceptible and measurable improvement in the health indicators in the country. All those cases of diarrhea, early deaths, and having those infectious diseases, communicable diseases so commonly affecting people, I think it's producing a sea change, and we need to take it forward in a big way. And I would like to congratulate NDTV and also Amitabh Bachchan ji, who has also spearheaded so many movements in the past, including my own passionate polio eradication movement. So this country can, I think, work wonders, and I'm sure that if we can really provide the successful implementation of the health for all goal of the World Health Organization, it is India itself which has the potential, the DNA, and the, I think, real spirit to be able to implement it. We very thoroughly believe that this cleanliness is, I think, next to godliness. This has been described in every religious text all over the world, and our people have all this ingrained in our DNA, and we have to only remind our people that this is so important, your personal hygiene. We have to take it to the schools, we have to make it a movement everywhere, and I know that under Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, with the inspiration of the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, we have done commendably well, and this is something which needs to be emulated by everyone. And in the next 5 years, and more particularly by 2022, we should be able to deliver a new India of the dream of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji.
Dr. Saab, this is Amitabh Bachchan. I just want to thank you for being with us and for giving us all these wonderful news on the kind of progress that India has made.
So happy. So
together on the polio campaign, so and successfully sold. Today, India is polio free after a long battle of almost 8 years. We worked together on that. We are now, as you know, and we've interacted with each other on diabetes, on tuberculosis, on hepatitis B, and we had Mr. Amitabh Kant telling us, giving us statistics of the kind of progress that is being made. I just feel, Dr. Saab, that detection and testing whether somebody is suffering from that disease is a very important element. Many of us, because of either lack of funds or just being lazy, never want to go to a clinic to get ourselves, just do a normal test and find out whether there is something wrong with them. We all know that diabetes is a silent killer. Many an individual who's suffering from diabetes is unaware that he is suffering from diabetes, right, and just one day becomes critical and passes away. We have as you know, we have been working on tuberculosis and hepatitis B, but we need a lot of government support in these two ventures, Dr. Saab. You know, I keep quoting my personal example all the time and try and propagate the idea of getting yourself detected. And I don't mind saying it publicly, you know, I'm a tuberculosis survivor. Right. I'm a hepatitis B survivor. Right. A bad blood infusion went in and 75% of my liver is gone. But because I was able to detect it, even after a period of 20 years, when 75% of my liver is gone, I'm still surviving on 25%. And this is what I'm able to propagate, that get yourself tested, get yourself diagnosed, and then there is a cure, even with tuberculosis. I didn't know for almost 8 years that I was suffering from tuberculosis. And I keep saying with a lot of immodesty, if it can happen to me, it can happen to anyone. And therefore, if you are not willing to get yourself tested, you'll never find out, and there's never going to be a cure for it. So can we have some kind of government support in pushing these awareness campaigns, where we know treatment is there, but to push the individual to go and get himself tested, diagnosed, so that the ailment can be found out?
Thank you, Amitabh ji. I am so happy that you are talking about diabetes, hepatitis B and tuberculosis, and I think that means a lot to me and that means a lot to the people of the country. You will be happy to know that all these diseases, and in fact all the other non-communicable diseases also, I think they are very high on the agenda of the government. As you know, by 2025 we want to eliminate tuberculosis in this country, although the international goal is to eliminate by 2030. And similarly for diabetes, hypertension and all these non-communicable diseases, I may tell you that the program that we have launched, the Ayushman program, has one component, which is the creation of the health and wellness centers all over the country. And we have a plan to create 1.5 lakh health and wellness centers by the end of 2022. We have already created 20,000. By March of 2020, we will be creating another 20,000, and so on and so forth. And at all these centers, our basic aim, and I think the strength that we are going to create and we are in the process of creating, is around prevention and promotive health, so that we can diagnose all these diseases early. Tuberculosis is one disease around which we have ensured that at every place, you see, even up to the level of the primary health center and the sub center, we have mechanisms to diagnose early with sophisticated machines like CBNet, the sputum, and there itself in the first instance we diagnose whether it's a routine tuberculosis or whether it is a drug resistant tuberculosis. For every patient of tuberculosis in the country, whether he is diagnosed in the private sector, the government provides 100% treatment, 100% facility for diagnosis, as well as treatment for drugs, etc. And the disease has been made notifiable. We have involved the private sector in a big way, and the results have already started showing. Similarly, it is true for the hepatitis B also. There is a great network of delivery of safe blood in the country, regional blood transfusion centers, the strengthening of the voluntary blood donation movement, and teaching people about the causes of hepatitis B, etc. So, in fact, I'm very happy to inform you that government is also very, very passionate about it and is trying to use every possible means, trying to use technologies, trying to use apps, trying to use its network of 10 lakh ASHA workers all over the country, the Anganwadi workers and the health workers at the grassroots level facilities, that is the sub-center. And we are in the process of developing a very huge social movement, and with people like you, who have always helped the cause of health over the years. And I remember, as environment minister, last 2 years you helped me in propagation and strengthening of the green good deeds movement also in the country. I'm sure that with people like you around us, who are also willing to spearhead this movement in a big way, we shall certainly be able to handle them appropriately and show significant positive results to the country. We are equally, the government and our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji is very, very passionate about health issues, and he wants to ensure that every countryman is delivered every possible health facility and also every possible preventive measure and also every possible health education through all possible technological tools also that are available to us today.
Thank you very much, sir.
I have been with you on a different context, standing in your open jeep in an election campaign, and we could see the reaction everybody have to you. You have a big heart. And we wish you the best, as much success here as you have in, among the people. Please, I agree with you, communicating all this to the people is crucial. Thank you very much for joining us. Thank you very much.
Thank
you. And all these youngsters here, how many of you believe cleanliness is most important, and you tell your parents also? Raise your hands. Let's see how many hands are there. The camera can... Even the youngsters in front also.
Yeah.
Wonderful. That's 99%. They can teach us.
Oh, yes.
You have a question? Or,
No, I'm really very impressed because I happened to go for Ganpati Puja to my neighbors who were just opposite my place, and after eating the prasad, I didn't know where to throw this, and the little kid, she's about this high, she said, "Come, uncle, I'll show you where to put it."
Wow.
And she showed me a dustbin. I said, "How do you know this?" "I know it because I want India to be clean."
Wow.
And so if it's going down to that level, it just shows how impressive and how powerful all
put
these
both your hands
are.
Up. Let's see how many are dirty. Hands up.
Hands up.
Now you're shy, is it?
Hey.
No, clean. Everybody's clean.
Everybody's
hands.
Clean, yeah.
Great. Okay, a very important aspect of this whole exercise is that it's not expensive to implement certain factors that cause hygiene and sanitation and therefore better health. And one of the great proponents of this is a person who I admire greatly, Professor Atul Gawande. He's at Harvard, he's high technology, but he's implementing in India with this various governments simple ways to educate people onto how to have hygienic conditions, particularly at childbirth. So we interviewed him a short while ago, actually at Davos. Just listen to, this is just a very small part of what he has to say, but he's doing wonderful work. Professor Gawande.
You know, the biggest risk to mothers to women is still childbirth and surviving childbirth and being able to be healthy afterwards. And of course, babies, you know, you have 3-5% who die in or around the time of birth. So that's a huge
number.
That's
1 in 20 babies die at the time of birth in India and and around the world.
I'm doing work in UP where it's 1 in 20, but it's 3% across all of India, which is exceedingly high.
And the rest of the world?
Less than 1 in 500. That the complexity of childbirth is that there are 30 things that we have discovered that make a huge difference in whether the baby and the mom live or die.
Now you've prepared a checklist of 30 items for childbirth in UP, for example.
Yes, and we're testing it. We actually first tested it in a community health center in Karnataka, but now we're rolling it out across 25 districts in UP. And the concept is that there are 30 basic things that are actually very complicated to deliver. It sounds so simple.
Things
you
like
got to wash hands.
Wash your hands.
Wash
at
your hands
at the time of childbirth.
Before the childbirth, before you touch the mother or touch the baby,
right.
You are always washing your hands. So what we're doing is we're having coaches come to the bedside, observe their care.
Right.
So nurses who will come and watch the care, record in a smartphone, did they wash hands? Did they have the medicines ready? Did they warm the baby? Did they treat bleeding properly? Give the feedback of the data to the frontline worker, to the manager of the hospital, the medical director. In the practices with putting in no new money, no new skills training, no new resources. The medicines are there, they just have to come to the right place. They may not have running water. But if the nurse can talk to the sweeper and say, bring a fresh basin of water to the bedside and a new bar of soap every time you clean the room, medicine and making healthcare work is like all of our world. The complexity is getting people to work together towards a common goal.
Since
I know that this is really cold in Davos, and it looks like you're having a cigarette, and that's injurious to health.
That is shocking. Let me tell you, it wasn't a tobacco cigarette.
No,
I never smoked cigarettes in my life.
Yeah.
Except once for style.
And it's one of the biggest polluters, so
it is.
We should remember that as well. Since Manisha Maiskar is going to leave us shortly, ma'am, it's you.
One
you,
more thing on cigarettes. My other hero in life, Dr. Shomiran Nandi, who is a wonderful doctor and surgeon, probably the only FRCS and FRCP in India, doesn't believe in medicine. He says you can take all the medicine, throw it into the ocean, the only thing worse off will be the fish. And he says, do anything you want in life, but don't smoke.
Yes. We have Paramayer now live, and he's the architect of the whole idea of this clean India, and he's been the man driving the whole process of trying to make India open defecation free and open defecation free plus, which means you maintain that status for as long as we can. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Iyer. And you've been the architect of this entire sort of movement towards sanitation, making sure everyone in India has access to toilets, and of course trying to keep all of India open defecation free. This year is meant to be our year of the big deadline, really, to get India open defecation free. Where are we at that?
Yeah, no, thank you very much for inviting me. Well, the real architect of this program is the Honorable Prime Minister. And, you know, he took the whole country by surprise, and indeed the world, when he said from his first Independence Day speech on 15th August 2014, exactly 5 years ago, that India would achieve open defecation-free status by the 150th birth anniversary of Gandhiji. And we are almost there. We are at about 99.5%+. And we are very much on track to achieve that by 2nd October. So I think that goal will be fulfilled. And as you mentioned now, we are moving on to sustaining that, because the work doesn't stop on sanitation. We need to make sure that all that behavior change which has been achieved in preventing people from defecating in the open, that needs to continue. So a lot of work ahead as well. But I think that that goalpost or that milestone set by the Prime Minister, that is very much going to be fulfilled.
Mr. Iyer, this is Amitabh, and needless to say, we've been working together in the many campaigns that the Honorable Prime Minister has initiated along with you, and you've been a great help, a great source of pushing us every day through your emails and through wonderful videos that you asked me to do in your campaign. But I'm really happy to hear all that you have achieved, Mr. Iyer, and indeed the Prime Minister. And I hope that you will continue with the same amount of invigoration and the capacity that you have to keep pushing this campaign every day. I hope that it will also reflect in our new campaign, which is called the Swasth Bharat campaign. I'm pretty sure that it will be successful as well.
Thank you very much, Param Iyer, for joining us. I want to tell you that none of this credit should go to you. It should go to your school, which was the same school that I went, right?
No, Pranoy, you're right. Actually, you know, I think I have to thank Amitabh ji, and we have been very pushy. He's been helping us in a phenomenal way. Right. So Swachh to Swasth. Actually, I think it's very complementary. Swachh and Swasth go very closely together. And in fact, as you mentioned, Pranoy, the best medicine, in fact, for preventing childhood diarrhea and stunting is actually the use of a toilet. And the Jan Andolan, which has been unleashed, where people of India have taken up this program, is actually led to phenomenal health outcomes already. As you probably know, the World Health Organization did a study which found that by the time the Swachh Bharat campaign ends, more than 3 lakh lives would have been saved, primarily of children below the age of 5. another study done by the Gates Foundation found that there's a very positive correlation between an ODF district and reduction in not only stunting but also improving nutritional outcomes. So I think this Swasth Banega campaign, which is very complementary to Swachh Banega India, is a great idea. A lot of work has been done already, and now I think we need to bring in also hygiene promotion, which I heard was being discussed on your program. So congratulations for this. We need to keep the work going. We need to sustain the ODF outcomes and move on to ODF Plus, which includes definitely working with the women and child department, focusing on nutrition. All this needs to come together to give us the best health impacts.
Mr. Iyer, I just want to add to what you've been saying and to the gentlemen that are watching this program. Mr. Iyer sent a message to me saying, you know, we have three students that want to come and chat with you about this Swachh India campaign. And they came and they asked various questions. And one of the questions they asked was, what is the reason for the success of the Swachh Bharat campaign? And I said, the reason is sitting in front of me. And they said, we can't understand. One of the guys is a student from UPenn. The other is a lady doing a PhD from Cambridge, and the other is also a gentleman doing PhD. If the Western world and their educational system is wanting to know how a campaign in India is succeeding, that is the reflection.
Fantastic.
It's a reflection, yeah.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much, Mr. Iyer, for joining us.
Sure.
With time for a short break, we'll be back with lots more. एक बार फिर से आप सभी का स्वागत है और अब हम सब चलते हैं अलवर जहां हमारी संवाददाता हर्षा कुमारी सिंह मौजूद हैं वहां पे टाटा ट्रस्ट ने एक बहुत अलग अनूठा सा इनिशिएटिव शुरू किया है जिसे कहते हैं चलो आंगनवाड़ी हम सभी को पता है आंगनवाड़ी बहुत जरूरी है सो ओवर टू यू हर्षा वहां पे क्या हो रहा है ये आंगनवाड़ियों के साथ
यस जैसे आपने कहा चलो आंगनवाड़ी बहुत बहुत जरूरी है और हमने जो स्वच्छ भारत का लॉन्च किया था उसके बाद स्वस्थ भारत की तरफ मूव कर रहे हैं इसका मतलब है कि जो आंगनवाड़ी केंद्र है वो केंद्र बन जाता है स्वस्थता जो हेल्थ है उसको फैलाने के लिए एक तरह से हेल्थ का मैसेज देने के लिए मेरे साथ हैं डॉक्टर प्रसाद जो टाटा फाउंडेशन से हैं और उन्होंने सबसे पहले कहा है कि अगर स्वस्थ होना है तो स्वच्छ भी होना है उसके लिए उन्होंने एक बहुत अच्छी चीज का आविष्कार किया
स्वच्छ का और स्वस्थ का संबंध दिखाता है ये हाथ धोने का कॉन्ट्रेप्शन जो है इसको टिपी टैप बोलते हैं
तो इसको आप लोग ने आविष्कार किया है इसका
हमने आविष्कार नहीं किया था सीखा था कहीं से लेकिन अच्छा। इसको बहुत बच्चे आराम से कर लेते हैं रेहान करके दिखाओ अपना हाथ करके दिखाओ धो के दिखाओ ये देखिए अपने आप बच्चा ऑपरेट कर लेता है अपने आप पानी निकलता है उसमें से और बच्चा साबुन लेकर हाथ धो लेता है अपने आप सिंपली ऑपरेटेड है
आंगनवाड़ी केंद्र कितना इम्पोर्टेंट है
बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट होता है हम जो कहते हैं सर जो सवेरे कह रहे थे कि खिलखिलाता बचपन और सेहतमंद माँ इन दोनों को तैयार करने के लिए आंगनवाड़ी केंद्र बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट होता है सरकार ने हर हजार के पॉपुलेशन पर एक आंगनवाड़ी खोली हुई है जहाँ पर पोषण के बारे में स्वच्छता के बारे में शुरू से बच्चों को सिखाया जाता है और माँ को जो हजार दिन का महत्व होता है वो हम शुरू से बताना शुरू करते हैं
चले लेट्स यस सो द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इज एज डॉक्टर प्रसाद वाज टेलिंग अस द आंगनवाड़ी इज वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट सो हियर इज द कॉन्ट्रैप्शन व्हिच अलाउज चिल्ड्रन टू वॉश देयर हैंड्स इज जस्ट अ कैन एंड द वाटर कम्स आउट ऑफ इट एंड चिल्ड्रन कैन वॉश देयर हैंड्स सो इवन इफ देयर इज नो वाटर समवन कैन एटलीस्ट फिल अ कैन एंड हियर इज द आंगनवाड़ी केंद्र Now, this is really, really important. We are talking about Chalo Anganwadi. Now, look at this big poster. Dr. Prasad, right here, sending an important message.
This is very important. We are standing in Machidi village in Anganwadi. Here, the Rajasthan government is going to run a campaign. Let's go to Anganwadi. So that people know that in Anganwadi, the 6 services are getting, how do they get? यहाँ पर दिखाया जाता है कि अलग अलग दिन पे जो एमसीएचएन दिवस होता है, गोद भराई, अन्नप्राशन, किस किस दिवस को होने वाले हैं, वो कार्यक्रम के बारे में बताते हैं।
इट्स वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग कि यू यूज ट्रेडिशनल फेस्टिवल्स लाइक ट्रेडिशनल रिचुअल्स, गोद भराई, अन्नप्राशन, एंड यू आर कन्वेइंग द न्यूट्रिशन मैसेज
ऑल ड्यूरिंग द 1000 डेज। गोद भराई इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू द 6th और 7th मंथ ऑफ द प्रेगनेंसी, टेलिंग द मदर अबाउट डाइट एंड रेस्ट। देन अन्नप्राशन इज अबाउट द 6th मंथ ऑफ द चाइल्ड, about complementary feeding to the child, the importance of it. So the 1000 days are covered in these things. We also have listed all the workers who are working here and the number of children that are attending this.
Accountability, how important is accountability is visible right here on the wall.
Yeah.
And now let's go across to these little children. I have the
Anganwadi
worker. Namaste. Kya naam hai?
Ji, Sunita Yadav.
Sunita, kya kya sikhate ho aap bachcho ko?
Shala Purv Shiksha mein hum in chart ke dwara bachcho ko
bas activity kya karate ho? Kuch activity kara ke dikhaiye.
Haan, zarur.
Jo haath dhone ka ek tarika bhi bataya tha na bachcho ke liye, wo bataiye.
Theek hai. Chalo bachcho khade ho jao sab ka sab. जल्दी फटाफट देखो हाथ गीला करते हैं पानी से, करो सब, आलिया खड़े करो बेटा, यू करो हाथ गीला करो, फिर साबुन लगाना है जोर से, साबुन लगा लिए, फिर यू करो अंगलियों के पीछे, फिर दूसरे हाथ पे करो, कर लिया, फिर उसके बाद में यू करो, पानी से हाथ धो और ऊपर करो यू करके।
कुछ गीत वगैरह गाते हैं क्या?
हाँ हाँ,
गवाइए ना फिर।
चलो कर, छोटी सी मुन्नी, बोलो जल्दी, गोटे वाली चुन्नी, लाल गुलाबी सूट, छोटे छोटे बूट, आंगनबाड़ी को जाते हैं, सबको टाटा करते हैं।
Maria. So now I also have with me someone who's very, very important in this, Sangeeta, who's the child project officer. Sangeeta, you really are the key between the government, the Tata Trust can do some, but just very quickly before we wrap, just one quick comment from you, how important is the Anganwadi center? Kitna mahatva hai iska?
Ji. आंगनवाड़ी केंद्र, क्योंकि आंगनवाड़ी केंद्र पर 0 से 6 वर्ष तक के बच्चों को पोषण तथा स्वास्थ्य संबंधी सेवाएं, इसके साथ साथ बच्चों को गुणवत्तापूर्ण शाला पूर्व शिक्षा दी जाती है, तो मैं कह सकती हूँ कि आंगनवाड़ी केंद्र एक मजबूत भारत के नींव प्रदान करता है।
और जो आपके साथ सरपंच है, क्योंकि हमारे पास टाइम नहीं है, आप लोग कितना समर्थन देते हो, सरकार आपको कुछ सुविधा दे रही है, कितना समर्थन है गांव?
हम हमारी ग्राम पंचायत की तरफ से स्वच्छ भारत अभियान के तहत पूर्णतः ओडीएफ करा दी गई है हमने ग्राम पंचायत को, और जो गंदगी रहती है उसके पानी की निकास, गंदे पानी की निकासी के लिए नाले बनवा दिए गए हैं, सब कार्य कर रहे हैं, और आंगनवाड़ी के लिए हमने डोर टू डोर जाकर कार्यकर्ता के साथ जो बच्चे वंचित रह रहे हैं उनके लिए आंगनवाड़ी आओ चले आंगनवाड़ी प्रयास कर रहे हैं,
तो बहुत जरूरी है, चलो आंगनवाड़ी। अगर कम्युनिटी का सपोर्ट नहीं होता है, लोगों का सपोर्ट नहीं होता है, तो ये सक्सेस नहीं हो पाएगा।
In fact, we would like to welcome Ravi Bhatnagar from Reckitt Benckiser, and we also have
he's
with us.
He's a motivating force behind all this. Amazing hard work.
Can I just interrupt? You know, this issue of the Anganwadi is really very important. They are the actual people that carry the message across. When we were working on polio and several other campaigns, it's that worker that goes down into the deepest regions of the country, through forests and through terrible terrain, to be able to go and deliver or talk about the campaign. So the Anganwadi is an extremely important element.
Really?
And the maximum amount of encouragement should be given to them.
Right.
Because they are the ones that actually take the message across to the
community. I'm glad you emphasize and reinforce that. Yeah.
And like we were saying, like she said, 0 to 6 years, so that's when the first 1000 days also come in.
Yeah,
absolutely.
So, and in fact, we also have Shweta Shalini joining us. She's the Executive Director, Maharashtra Village Transformation. So I think, Shweta ji, why don't you tell us, jo ye village transformation ka kaam jo Maharashtra mein ho raha hai, especially Amravati, where pe bahut malnutrition is a huge challenge.
Okay, so first and foremost, let me tell you that it's been a trend in India that community problems were always solved by individual solutions. And if you actually look at the past few years, what we've done is community problems are being solved by two simple words. One is collaboration and the second one is convergence. What is the basic difference between collaboration and convergence? So collaboration is aap aur main ek saath aaye aur phir apne kaam pe jud jaye
calm is statistics. We know that this much stunting is there. This is what we want to achieve. This is where we collaborate and get to work. The other thing is, aap apna kaam kare, main apna kaam karun. We are supposed to be designated for certain work. We both converge together and then reach the same goal. This is convergence. Main aksar kehti hun is baat ko, phir dohrana chahti hun, ki mujhe kisi ne kaha ki jis samay Amit ji polio drops ki awareness lekar logon tak pahunche, polio disappeared from India. I think this is exactly what happened when we started the Swachh campaign. Everyone converged together. He did his job, we did our job. We definitely need few people who understand their own job, come back with passion. That's what RB did with us. So Reckitt Benckiser came with us with this plan, and I thank Gaurav and Ravi both, because...
Ma'am, I want to interrupt.
Yes, sir.
You said that, you know, about the polio campaign and it being very impressive. There's a story behind this as to why it was successful. And when we were invited to United Nations in New York to, you know, celebrate our success, one of the people who was there said, you know, what do you attribute this success to? And I said, there's an incident of a village woman who is like an emblem for this campaign. So what was happening in polio was that nobody was understanding what this campaign is.
Right.
And then the agency and we sat together and said, how to put it across? So the agency came about with a novel idea. They said, you know, you have an image of getting angry on screen, so why don't you make this campaign angry, you know, get annoyed with the people. So
that's
I did a campaign and said, kyun nahi aap gaye wahan polio karne, jaiye jaldi jaiye. So that woman that was in the village said, oh, Amitabh ji aaya, bahut naraaz the, isliye main maar gayi.
So, you know, one of the things,
sir,
good
just
idea.
To extend this, I know a lot of people who say, and a lot of kids are sitting here, a lot of kids who tell their parents ki kachra feka na to main Amit ji aur Modi ji se bata dunga. So, you know, it's just extending that image, and we are so thankful that you have come.
Abhi tak koi aaya nahi hai.
You have come together with us on this Swasth program, because very categorically I want to bring this point. Let's look at statistics. 34% children between the age group of 1 to 5 are stunted. But the big thing is 60% of the other kind are obese. So for us, Swasth kya hai? Sanjeev ji is sitting here, I don't want to say it. Today we have local ingredients which are as nutritious, but the education of what nutrition should the child be given is something that we have forgotten. And it has been traditionally there. When RB partnered with us, they came back with not a program to actually look at promoting a certain product, but they came back with us to actually study the demography, to actually study the ethnography and educate mothers in the first 1,000 days and make that impact. And that's why I think convergence of these efforts are extremely important. We've piloted this in Amravati, yeah, in Melghat, yeah, and we've seen tremendous response. I think we are still not to the measurable limit of where we can measure things and show some results, but I think I'm happy that we've started.
Ravi, you've also been involved in this very closely, right?
Yeah.
From RB? You're leading the whole thing.
Yes.
Has been a good experience?
Yeah, it's basically like, you know, how we look into the whole program is, the first component is on the breastfeeding. We need to strengthen the breastfeeding, because the breastfeeding rates really, really needs to be, we have to do something on that. There needs to be a conducive environment for the women so that they can, there are a lot of migrant women in these two districts where we work. So creating the breastfeeding pod for them, creating an environment so that, you know, women can actually do it. And also thinking about, like, you know, there are some women who can actually, who can't breastfeed. Talking to, you know, those, like, why, what's the problem? So there's some, you know, the indigenous knowledge, what they have. They say, like, when you eat the millets or when you eat some other local crops, you produce more milk, you can lactate, as well as many needs the medical intervention also. And, but largely it's a socio-medical intervention on which we are working on. And ethnography was the first thing, like, you know, in today's India, we are talking about, like, there is the Anganwadi worker and the community, they are not able to speak one language. The doctors in the primary health center and the tribal population, one is talking in the, you know, Bagri or Bheel or some dialect, and the doctors who come from the, you know, urban places, there's a total mismatch, and they can't understand what's the problem. Next thing what we are seeing is, the use of technology. The standardization of technology, like, you know, first 28 days of the child's life is very important. That's the time when hypothermia happens to the kids. The temperature suddenly falls. We thought, like, can we do something on that? And, you know, we introduced that in the basic healthcare kit for the moms. If a kid's temperature is going down, a machine gives a signal to the moms in terms of a beep. And the mom brings child near to the chest as a kangaroo care. And, you know, that will lead to, you know, the better life of the child, and right, the hypothermia can be taken care of. But just a few things.
One quick thing that I wanted to add here was, see, we've called this entire program VSTF, Village Social Transformation Foundation. This social change takes a lot of time. But when leaders like this come with us, yeah, we understand Ravi is somebody who can lead this entire change through technology, yeah, through huge back-end educational support. We've made some tremendous advances as far as tools are concerned, and that is what is making the impact.
Sorry, we are now being joined by Mr. Indu Bhushan. He's the CEO of Ayushman Bharat. Now, this scheme aims at making interventions in primary, secondary, and tertiary care systems covering both preventive and promotive health to address healthcare holistically. Mr. Bhushan, thank you so much for joining us. And the WHO report has said that villages that are ODF have seen a reduction in diarrhea. This has been recorded statistically. So how do you see Swachhata in a big way leading to a Swasth India in the long term?
Thank you very much for inviting me to this show. And also I thank NDTV for launching this great Banega Swasth India campaign, and we believe that you had first Banega Swachh India, and Swachh India, Swachh Bharat was a huge success, and I hope that Banega Swasth India will also lead to a excellent implementation of Ayushman Bharat, which has the making India healthy as a main objective. And it's correct that sanitation and health are closely linked. And as Mr. Iyer before me had mentioned, that because of Swachh Bharat, because of open defecation free India, more than 3 lakh child death have been averted. And so there is a close link. And within Ayushman Bharat, as you mentioned, we have two components. One component focusing on preventive and promotive health, and other one on curative health.
Mr. Bhushan, I would like to ask you, does this actually mean, you know, obviously there are funds allocated and it's a big mission, the Ayushman Bharat mission, when we're looking at health, and even Mr. Iyer said that health is the most important thing. So does this mean that the government hospitals and public health centers would get upgraded, and especially when we are talking about rural health centers?
Obviously, you know, you have to see this, that currently health is provided by both public sector and private sector. And of course, we need to strengthen our public sector hospitals, but also acknowledge that 70% of our services are actually provided by the private sector. And so far, what is happening is that the private sector services are not accessible to the poor. And one major thing that we see in our country is that more than 60% of health expenditure comes out of pocket, and out of pocket means that people have to pay to get those services. The question would be that why is out of pocket service expenditure bad? Because we are providing out of pocket for everything else. For education we provide out of pocket, for tourism we provide out of pocket. With health, out of pocket is both actually inefficient and inequitable. Inefficient because when you have to pay from your pocket, then you tend to delay the treatment, or you go to less effective treatment place like a local doctor where you have to go to some tertiary care doctor, or when you take the treatment you don't complete it. And particularly the problem is that the out-of-pocket expenditure is regressive. For poor people, that constitutes a large amount of expenditure from their income, and also it's a double whammy because the person who gets sick also can't work. So when the person gets sick, it's not that person who suffers, the whole family suffers. And also what happens is that they have to borrow heavily from outside, and that also constrains or impairs their ability to come out of poverty. So we have studies that show that every year about 6 crore people fall into poverty because of expenditure on health. Of course, that's not acceptable, and the scheme Ayushman Bharat is focused on that, to prevent people from falling into poverty by use of both public sector hospitals and private sector hospitals. There is a huge push to improve the quality of private public sector hospitals, but also provide incentive for private sector hospitals to service poor people.
This is Amitabh here. I just want to know, you said 70% of the private hospitals is 70% and 30% in rural areas. So I'm assuming that most of the talented doctors go to the private sector and the public sector doesn't get the talent. What do we do about that?
Well, Mr. Bachchan, I think it's slightly more complex, because if you look at the quality of services, I would still rate AIIMS or many of the tertiary care public sector hospitals as one of the best, which has biggest or best talent or skills available. But you're right, on an average, most of the qualified or talented doctors and physicians would like to be in big cities and in private sector, because that's where the paying capacity is. But we need to understand that this scheme, Ayushman Bharat, Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, is changing that equation. So far, doctors were going to big cities because that's where the business was, that's where the paying capacity was. Now, with this scheme, we have given the paying capacity to the poor people who are living in tier 2, tier 3 cities and rural areas, and we are hoping that with this demand side financing, which is financing people to, which is putting rupees in the hand of the people in rural areas, also supplies response will come, and these doctors and medical hospitals will tend to open in tier 2, 3 and tier 3 cities and rural areas.
Thank you. I do feel though it is a worry. Do you think it's a concern that one should be?
There's always this, you know, difference. You know, why should I go to the village when I can earn more in the city?
Yeah.
And I don't know. It's a social problem. I don't know what it is, but you still have a lot of qualified doctors on their own, in their own private capacity, go and do charitable work.
Yeah.
They've left the city,
motivated,
gone to the villages, and started their own clinics and helped thousands and thousands of villagers, all free of cost. So that's very motivation.
Doctor-patient ratio is very bad in India.
Yeah.
Very few number of doctors to thousands of patients. The ratio is extremely poor. That's the major challenge.
So all of you children, become doctors. We need you. India needs you.
I just wanted to add that, you know, while you're absolutely right, Mr. Bachchan, but this government has been trying very hard, and it's really starting to work, this linking of the private and the public. You know, it's already in Ayushman Bharat, as Dr. Bhushan talked about. It's already happening in the tertiary care facilities, where you have the choice to either go to a private or a public facility, and it will slowly trickle down to primary too. So I think hopefully we'll see a balance there. But we do have a challenge where there are not enough qualified people.
Yeah.
So that's going to be
how many of you kids?
I think the differentiation hurts.
How many of you kids like rap? Raise your hands.
What?
Well, not bad. Well, we've got a 14-year-old who's going to do a rap song on this whole topic. He's just 14 and has come down just for this because he's really motivated. Let's give him a round of applause and then you start.
दिल्ली में महंगाई हाई फाई प्रदूषण करता है भरपाई
लड़कियों की जाने कैसे बचाए, भ्रष्टाचार हम कैसे मिटाए, दिल्ली की जनता मुझे बताए, दिल्ली की जनता मुझे बताए। सब जानते हैं दिल्ली यहाँ की राजधानी है, पर कम यहाँ पर पानी है, ये दादी की नहीं कहानी है। मैं दिल्ली में ही रहता हूँ, सारे गम मैं भी सहता हूँ, ये आम लोगों पे व्यंग है क्योंकि आज नहीं है मेरे संग है। ये अपने घरों को तो साफ रखते हैं पर गलियों में गंदगी फैलाते हैं, फिर बीमारियों से ये घिर जाते हैं, फिर दोष ये सब पे लगाते हैं। हम सब यही चाहते हैं, जिस मुकाम पर है दिल्ली उससे उसको ऊपर उठाना है। दिल्ली है राजधानी, हमें राजधानी दिल्ली को बनाना है। यो
teach you to rap.
Yeah, sure, I'd love to learn.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. That's brilliant. Thank you. We now have Saurabh, our colleague who's in Amravati. Saurabh, you've been there now the whole day. Why don't you tell us what's happening there with the whole situation, nutrition, health, swachhata? Why don't you just give us an idea?
Well, a couple of interesting things happening here. Like you said, you know, we've been watching this place for years now. Amravati, Melghat has been a center where malnutrition has been reported. But what we see now is actually interventions at the village level. And here, of course, you can see, you know, children being studied, all kinds of immunization that is required. The medical officers from the government all here making these checks. These are done every week. And also on the other side here, we have these community nutrition workers who actually engage with the pregnant women and their families to tell them what's going on. I have with me one of them here, and I'll try and speak to them. Aap inko kya bata rahe? Actually, what you see here, if I can ask them to show you, this is a game that they're playing, and through this game, women are being taught what they should be doing. To kya bata rahe inko? Isme kya likha hai?
हम इन्हें गुड हैबिट्स एंड बैड हैबिट्स फॉर द फर्स्ट डेज, फर्स्ट 100 डेज के बारे में बता रहे हैं, जिसमें इसमें लिखा है कि मंची अच्छी आदतें और बुरी आदतें। एग्जाम्पल हो गया कि प्रेग्नेंट महिलाओं को अपना लसीकरण टाइम पे करना चाहिए, और जो बुरी आदतें हैं कि प्रेग्नेंट महिलाओं को अपना लसीकरण टाइम पे नहीं कराना चाहिए।
एंड दीज कम्युनिटी न्यूट्रिशन वर्कर्स ट्रैवल फॉर डेज on foot sometimes to reach the homes. आप क्या बताते जब किसी के घर ऐसे पहुंचते? ये विलेज बहुत ही रूरल है, बहुत ही रिमोट है, क्या बताते उनको?
मैं घर पे जब पहुंचती हूँ, तो अगर प्रेग्नेंट वुमन के घर में पहुंचती हूँ, तो उनको मैं बताती हूँ कि आप प्रेग्नेंट हो तो आपका जो आहार है वो दिन में नहीं पे तो तीन यानी चार से छह बार खाना चाहिए, ठीक से आराम करना चाहिए, लसीकरण करना चाहिए, ये सारी बातें मैं बताती हूँ उनको, वीडियो के तौर पे बताती हूँ, ऐसे भी बताती हूँ।
एंड ऑल्सो लाइक वी बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट फ्रॉम स्वच्छ टू स्वस्थ, मैम आप जब घर पे जाते हैं स्वच्छता के बारे में क्या बताते हैं उनको?
स्वच्छता के बारे में बताते हैं कि हाइजीन कैसे मेंटेन करना है, कैसे क्या प्रेगनेंसी के टाइम में कौन सी केयर देना है, कैसे करना है, बच्चों को कैसे ट्रीट करना है।
And we have Navneeta ma'am here also. Ma'am, if I can ask you, ma'am, the technology that now we are seeing being involved here, what is that technology? Tell us a little bit about that.
See, there are many adversities, as you people know, because of diversity and then the remoteness of the area. So we have deployed human-centric design to design all our interventions. Each and every intervention is now based on mobile applications. So this kind of mobile applications we have. So all of our CNWs, they carry tablets to record those.
We spoke about.
So they carry this kind of tablets to on which they record the data. They carry the interventions. We have system designed videos which they use for all BCC activities. Now these are the real time data which we are capturing for this project, which gets in fact reflected in our dashboards and help us to design the next level of the intervention.
And that perhaps is where technology comes in, because as you know, Amravati and especially Melghat is a district that is malnutrition prone, if that's a term one can use. And we've seen these interventions on the ground, and what people have been telling us that these interventions are working, but clearly there's a lot more to do as far as, you know, becoming a Swasth India from a Swachh India.
Thank you so much, Saurabh, for sharing that with us. In fact, Gaurav, I would like to ask you here that you're working very closely in the region. And even the Prime Minister, he's actually said that good nutrition is the foundation of new India. The Poshan Abhiyan talks about tackling malnutrition till 2022. What are your thoughts about nutrition when we really look at it as a country?
Well, as people have said, the first 1,000 days is where
you intervene and you make a difference. Nutrition, apart from hygiene, is one of the biggest problems that India faces today. If you have wasted, malnourished children who don't live the potential, that obviously hampers their lives, poverty, and also this country. So getting the right food, getting local food, which people don't know about, education is extremely important. There's stuff that we have learned in ethnography study in this area, faith-based healers. People go to faith-based healers who do their own stuff and nothing happens. So we are actually getting faith-based healers to refer people to hospitals, and we are actually helping them out. So we are saying, okay, if you refer people to faith, to hospitals, we will pay you 300 rupees. We are paying people, when somebody said today that when you fall sick, you lose your wages, your whole family. So we are paying people who are going to these public health service centers daily loss of wage, so that they are motivated to send their family member or the mother to go and put the child there and stay with the child when he or she is born. So there are many other things that are involved apart from just pure good food.
So what, Gaurav, I just asked a fundamental question, motivated you into getting into this area, because it's wonderful, and I hope all other corporates follow this example of, and you're the force behind all of this. So what motivated you into this?
No, Dr. Roy, I mean, our focus, one, is stems from our vision, which our CEO had said, which is of health and hygiene and how healthy lives and better homes. So that is our motivating force. But the kind of success we have seen in the last 5 years with the Swachh program, the kind of this country coming together and working together, it's a natural progression for us to move towards better. It's not that we will stop our hygiene programs, our school program will continue, our forestation program will continue, our diarrhea program will continue, all that will continue. But to make a direct impact on real impact on lives of people in these first 1,000 days is now. So breastfeeding, malnutrition, neonatal problems, all of that is where we are moving towards, and it's very natural.
So like we've been talking about 1,000 days, obviously in India another huge issue is anemia. So Sanjeev, I would like to ask you, what are those things which actually mothers can have, because lactation is a huge issue, tackling anemia, so what are those things which even household, like people say good is good, you know, what are those things which people can take?
So yeah, I think anemia is a big issue. Dr. Hemlata is there, and she can do that. But I think most of the time, when any information is given, it is given in a way which makes it boring. People know it, but whether they adopt it or not, that's the key. So we all know that dark leafy vegetables are good. So all that information is there. I think there is a dichotomy. There is knowledge is there, information is there, but adoption may be very low. So I think people need to collaborate and make information interesting. And once we do that, I think, so we are working on few things where we make it interesting. We say, ki, 2 minutes I have with you. You give me 2 minutes, I'll give you health, right? So something like that on social media. And so there are, let's say, FSSI has, they are trying to disseminate all the information on this in a great way, through small videos, through different pictorially, to different kinds of people, social groups, all of that. I think we need to collectively understand that its information is there, but how do people get it? They have to get it.
So, but I think another way, like this is nutrition, anemia, another very important aspect when we are talking about healthy India, Neeraj, I would like to ask you is about immunization and vector-borne diseases. I think Ravi and Neeraj, if you can just take us through that briefly.
I was just going to say we've forgotten about immunization.
Yeah, you know, that's a very important point.
As a public health professional, I don't know if you're aware, but this is actually the best investment for impact, for health. And this, in the last few years, Mission Indradhanush has done a lot towards that. So most of the children that are dying in India are due to diarrhea and pneumonia. And two vaccines that have been introduced over the last few years, one is the rotavirus, which alone would probably save about 60 to 70,000 children every year once it's rolled out completely. And the second one is pneumococcal vaccine, which is also being rolled out.
Can I just interrupt you there? In terms of diarrhea, apart from the vaccine, just cleanliness is a major, would reduce a lot of
diarrhea problems, right?
So, Dr. Roy, prevention is always going to be hygiene and sanitation.
Right.
But by the time, I mean, till we are getting there, vaccines is critical to just save the lives today.
They're not mutually exclusive. You should do both.
They're not. And I mean, the hope is that one day you don't need the vaccine because you are already in such a clean environment. But you also see in measles, for example, in the United States, if you're watching, you know, they got rid of measles. They stopped vaccinating their children. And now they're going back to it.
Yep.
So there are those challenges of public health.
Yes. So vaccination and vector-borne diseases, that's again something which we are, it's every time, across parts of the country we hear. Ravi, what do you,
In English, what do you mean by vector-borne?
Mosquitoes. So
you are not vector borne.
Like malaria and
dengue. Because of.
So that's shocking. People have to get it. People have to get all that we're saying. I think we say this.
But like AES is something I would just like to talk about is, people don't know what is the cause behind AES. People were not eating lychees.
Japanese and AES.
Thank you very much.
You mentioned about the campaign, the Indradhanush. Does it include all the diseases?
It includes all the vaccines that are being introduced and trying to get to 100% coverage.
Because there are many diseases that are not included in it.
There are still, TB, for example, we had the BCG, but we don't have a TB vaccine, which is currently under trial. Yeah,
that's what I was trying to get at, because we need to push through the government, either a separate campaign or include it in the Dhanush.
Absolutely. So there are
neither does hepatitis B.
Hepatitis B, there are lots of vaccines which are being worked on. Dengue is growing every year, and there is a vaccine. Yeah.
So for the viewers, AES.
So that's the Japanese.
Just for the viewers, what is it?
It's Japanese encephalitis. You know, in you get it a lot in UP, Bihar, in those areas, which kills children.
AES.
It targets children in a very bad way, and the survival rate's very, very. Yeah. So Ravi's been working on it. Ravi, why don't you tell us? Since you've been working on it.
It's very interesting. So yesterday I was with the Yogi ji in Gorakhpur, and he awarded some of the doctors, paramedics, frontline health workers on the work which has been put together. So he showed some data and statistics yesterday, like how the deaths are coming down, and how overall preparedness has grown in the region. Credit goes to PATH also, credit goes to the frontline health workers. There's a lot of work which we have also done in that area. So one part is the collaboration part, like sanitation we took care of, hand washing we took care of, vaccine part someone else was working on. The most important thing what we see is the nudges. So what are the audio nudges you are working with so that you simplify the concept of AES to the communities, and what are the video nudges which you use actually to amplify it, and how sticky your messages are? Are you able to actually tell to the communities like this problem is really serious, you need to stop open defecation in the open, you need to work on the places where the mosquito breeding is happening, you need to cut those places. And then a lot of community engagement. Again, the Anganwadis are one of the very, very important places in the village community. How to strengthen Anganwadis? So government in UP has significantly worked on that in the regions. And on the top of that, we also see like the disease is also skewed. It's not like just, there's not a balance. So girls are getting it more and boys are getting it less, and deaths are happening more on girls and boys are getting less deaths of the boys. So there's a gender difference also which plays a very important role.
Right.
So seeing the problem more holistically is very important.
We are now being joined by our colleague Manadipa Banerjee from Kolkata, who tells us will tell us about the Smile on Wheels initiative, a custom-tailored medical mobile unit with modern equipment, which is made available to cater the essential primary health needs of beneficiaries, especially women and children in inaccessible areas. Over to you, Manadipa. Please tell us about this initiative.
That's right. Let me first introduce you to the place where I'm at. I'm at a place called Bashanti Colony, and this is in Ultranga, and this is pretty much the heart of the city. Now, Bashanti Colony is a kind of slum, if you want to call it that, a collection of about 3,000 homes in narrow lanes like this. And you can see the lanes absolutely narrow. There are, since the morning that I've been here, I've seen women carrying water in buckets. So there is a difficulty with water supplies. And of course, most of the people living here are daily wage earners. And for them, sometimes it's a choice between going to hospital for medical care or going and earning your daily income, something that you can buy your chawal dal with and cook a meal at night. In which situation, something like this mobile van really, really comes in handy. And they have been here for several hours now. I have seen a stream of people, honestly, mostly women and children coming to the doctor, you know, showing their old prescriptions, showing, asking for new ones, and also medicine being distributed. Apparently, medicine is distributed free. Let me first go to these ladies over here and ask them how useful is this. Didi, eta howar karone apnar ki shubidhe hocche barir kache? হাসপাতাল কত দূর?
অনেক দূরে, আরজিকল
অনেক দূর। আর ওখানটা গেলে
ওখানটা লাইন দিতে যেতে সারাদিন চলে যায় আর কি, এটাই ব্যাপার।
The closest hospital, RG Corps, which is very far from here, and for them, going there and standing in a queue for a whole day means the loss of a livelihood, so they come here. And I'll just get a quick word in from this gentleman over here, Satnam, the best USP of this.
So the best USP of this whole model is that we are focusing on the curative part, that is, we are addressing the immediate health needs of the people. At the same time, we are taking care to enhance the health-seeking behavior by creating awareness in the communities about various diseases. And also, we are working in convergence with the government so that from the single window, the services can be delivered to the beneficiaries and to the community.
And service to the doorstep, that is the moot point of Smile on Wheels, this initiative that has been going on for the last 4 years. There are three such vans in Kolkata, I believe, and they serve a huge community. You know, NDTV Dettol, Banega Swasth India, for the people in Bashanti Colony, nothing could be more appropriate and required than services at their doorstep like this.
Thank you so much for joining us, Monadeepa, and for that. And now for a very special part of this launch that we've done. Basically, of this year's health campaign, it's the Swasth Box. It's a special package of essential and basic requirements put together for economically challenged mothers and newborns. And I would like to call upon Mr. Shantanu Mishra, co-founder Smile Foundation, Seema Kumar, health expert Smile Foundation, to unveil this box. And so this is
the box that we are going to give as part of the campaign and raise. Viewers can send in donations, and mothers will get this, and it'll really help them. But before we do that, you see, never change a winning body. Be hygienic.
We need somebody to design this for me because I don't have the right and appropriate dialogue. But you know, please listen to what Pranay is saying and contribute. You know, as
Hindi
much
mein,
as you can.
Hindi mein.
Jitna bhi aap de sakein. Aapka yogdan jo hai, wo na jaane kitne logon ki zindagiyon ko sudhar sakta hai. To ye jo Swachh Box hai. इसमें यदा कदा एक दिन अगर आपने आइसक्रीम कम खाई तो उसमें डाल दिया, आइसक्रीम नहीं रुपया, ताकि ये जो बक्सा है इसमें जितनी भी धनराशि इकट्ठा होगी ये किसी माँ को दी जाएगी जिसके पास साधन नहीं है कि वो अपने बच्चों का या अपना इलाज करा सके. बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आपका.
There's Dettol wipes.
Dettol bhi hai iske andar.
There's sanitary pads.
Sanitary pad bhi hai.
Baby blanket.
Bachchon ke liye to kambal hai.
Yeah, there's mosquito net, you know, to prevent vector-borne diseases.
Yeah, yeah.
From mosquitoes.
Machhardani bhi hai isme.
And then there's nail cutters. There's zinc.
Nakhun wagera kaatne ke liye.
There's zinc. There's a cotton roll. There's a baby wrap.
Slowly. Hindi also.
Cotton roll.
Rui ke tukde.
Baby wrap.
What is a baby wrap?
It's, I think, like a little wrap, and you know, swaddling.
Bachchon ko, yeah.
And then there's small sustainable toy for kids, like a little toy.
छोटे-छोटे खिलौने भी हैं उसके अंदर.
Yeah. And then there's feeding bowl and spoon.
जी जी.
कटोरी चम्मच. Baby oil. Dettol hand wash. Literature on the kangaroo mother care, as Ravi said, you know, that blanket that tests temperatures, and if the temperature drops, the mother can hold the baby against her chest.
वो जो literature उसकी भाषा क्या होगी वो समझाना पड़ेगा.
It's in both languages, Hindi both and English. English. It's in Hindi and English. Then there's literature on breastfeeding, how to, why it's important, all of that. That's also in both languages. There's literature on hand washing, very crucial. That's also in both languages. And then there's the hypothermia alert device. Why don't you do the?
ये बक्सा मिलेगा कहाँ पर?
And yeah, so why don't you do it, Mr. Bachchan? Like you can open the box to show it to everybody.
Thank you,
Mr. Bachchan. Why don't you open the box?
Thank you so much. ये बक्सा मिलेगा कहाँ लेके?
Yeah, yeah.
ये बक्सा मिलेगा कहाँ?
So sorry, ma'am, if you can come closer to me, since yes. I have the mic.
Right.
If you can just
come and just explain all this.
Yeah. And Ravi, why don't you come? Why don't you join us?
Some of the things are very standard. But so one of the interesting thing, one is the thing that Ravi spoke about, the hypothermia device, which rings as soon as the kid. So, and at the other end is something that we've realized plays a huge role, a cloth, as you asked, sir. A cloth, because today when the baby is born in a village, people resort to a dirty cloth in their house. So they tear the cloth and wrap the baby. It leads to a huge amount of infection. So as simple as stuff like a
baby wrap,
a wrap, to as technology driven like a hypothermia care. So we've tried to include different ends of the spectrum in this box, which helps to save lives, and we hope we can.
Thank you very much.
Through your message, through NDTV, we can donate as many boxes as we can.
You know, Amitabh, we've already raised funds for this,
yeah.
And we're looking for more and more. And on October the 2nd, we'll get. So we could have thousands and thousands and thousands of these, depending
what
on.
What is the price of this?
This is
4,700.
Yes.
And.
Per box.
Yeah, so
per
everybody box. Goes out and sells this, or people come and buy it?
Actually, this is not for us.
We'll be donating it,
It is
we'll be donating it to mothers.
We'll raise mothers, the money, so buy boxes,
the money
and give it to mothers.
Donate it to mothers across villages.
I want to make a donation of 100 such boxes.
Thank you so much.
Wow.
We did that for
whatever,
challenges.
Whatever we get through this whole campaign, RB will donate exactly the same amount.
Wow,
we'll match that.
And also, I just want to say that.
Thank you very much.
Ma'am, I know that this is quite costly. So this is for special, as Ravi said, it will be for really vulnerable children.
Actually,
so without this, what would be the cost of the box?
This is 2,000 rupees.
Yeah.
1,500, sorry. We negotiated with the company.
We got it for 1,000 rupees.
Okay, great. Yeah. So it is minus 1,000, 3,700.
So we'll include that.
Why can't you include that? Actually, this is for underweight kids. 1.8 kg kids, you know,
super sensitive kids.
Yeah. Those who need the alarm to be made for their going down.
And also, because it tests temperature, correct me if I'm wrong, it needs batteries and it needs electricity.
So it has that.
Yeah.
You just pull it and show this.
The little hat.
That's for you.
This is a vest for you, or wrapper.
Oh, this is a swaddle cloth.
This is a cloth.
Yeah.
This you can.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, and then there's soap, very important.
There's a blanket.
Yeah, there's a blanket.
Lovely.
See, and that's all it
here
is.
Here you just put it in the wrist of the kid, the baby. And then the temperature goes down.
It'll beep.
It alarms. It alarms the mother to give the kangaroo mother care, connecting with the
skin. Why would the temperature go down?
That's the hypothermia condition called. When the child is very weak at times, you know, because of the infections and the low.
It goes below normal?
Yes.
Yeah.
Very
that's
alarming.
Very, very
and,
dangerous.
This is one major cause of the infant deaths also.
So the moment it goes down, that meter beeps.
This beeps.
Then all the mother has to do is take the baby,
and hold it
skin to skin, and it's
soft. And these wraps and also are going to help, you know, give the child a little warmth. And if it still doesn't settle down, one needs to rush to the doctor.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But a lot of it can be stopped right there.
Yeah, but it also beeps when the temperature goes up. Am I correct? So it detects both the lower and the higher temperature. So if both temperatures don't adjust, then you know you've got to take the baby to the doctor. Yeah.
Even something as simple as a nail cutter, Mr. Bachchan, which people we take for granted, they actually use, you know...
No, it's the worst blade. Place for infection.
Worst place when the mother is feeding, rather than using a blade, a nail cutter can change the hand hygiene. Yeah.
That's habits. A good...
And Mr. Bachchan, like working with Smile, you know, like in the last 15 years in this area, community engagement programs, pan-India, we have realized, we have learned so many stories, we have learned a lot how to engage with the community, work with the challenges and find the solutions there only. So there are myths that you don't need to cut the nails of the kid, you know, it's not auspicious. So mother bites the nails of the kid, grown up the nails, to make it smoothen. And if not cut, it's going to infect the child also. So the baby nail cutter is one interesting thing.
Something about Saturday or something like that. Don't cut your nails on Saturday.
Oh, yes.
I must say that this is not absolutely original. KCR in Telangana, every mother goes into a hospital to have a baby, gets a box with similar things. And I've seen them. The mothers are so happy and they benefit so much from just this simple for the first few days.
It's kit like this.
Telangana does this.
One more upgradation to this kit. So all the literature what we are creating will be in Braille also. And we are also creating the audio books for the moms who actually can't see or can't read. So we are also working towards that.
So Smile will be implementing this. We are like to add something more. When we go in the regional pockets, we are going to translate it in simple regional language so that Anganwadi workers can also, you know, read out. And also some small handbooks like comic books, which is interesting to know how my child can be healthy. So that is also going to be part of this.
Okay, everybody, thank you all very much, particularly you youngsters at the back there. Thank you very much. We're moving from Swachh to Swasth to make India a healthier place. And no better way to end than let's have that rap song again. And you'll dance to it.
You could just say 2nd October, we'll be back with the big
On the 2nd of October, we're going to be back with the big telethon, where we're going to be here throughout the day talking about Swasth India and thanking NDTV and the entire crew for it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Swasth takya. Pehle swasth the, abhi swasth hona bahut zaruri, bahut zaruri. Kaam kiya, khana khaya, haath dhoya nahi. Gande haath, bina dhakkan glass, pani pita wahi. Kitanu palta wahi. Germs tere haath dho ke piche pade haath dho le pehle bhai baad mein le khana bade manaveli ghar mein kharcha kam kyu karta kachra sadta jata gandagi bhi badhti jati 10 bimari tere piche lagi bach bimari se nanne bachcho ko bhi rakh bimari se dur swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega ha ye shot hai bhai swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega india swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega banega ke nahi bhai Swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega India har jawan ladka ladki soche parivartan karna jisme jitna dam hai utna jis tarah se khate peete usme kitna kya nutrition iska solution kya hai information leke pehle khud ko kare durust namrata ki bhasha dwara mita de sara dusht rog wala ration passion sahi jagah lag jave aur auraton ki fikre dil mein kathin kuch nahi koshish dwara aanganwadi aasha dwara ek swasth bharat bana de swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega banega kya swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega india swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega 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 swachh banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega tabhi to swasth banega india Nays the bar in the house boy this is how we do it sawdhan public health pe dhyan do healthy ban jao kya swasth ban jao ek swasth jeevan bitao aur machao kya hai